Hi Pisces, we are home. I am home. I'm so glad I'm here. Welcome back to the channel, guys. This is for Pisces Sun Moon Rising. How are you guys feeling? I have been feeling very drained, very mellow, hardly have any energy to speak. That's one of the reasons I'm not able to do these readings, because I'm finding it really hard and it takes a lot of energy to for me to speak. Now, I know it sounds like weird, but yeah, that's what's happening to me, and I'm fumbling. Apart from that, I was talking to Capricorn and Aquarius about how Saturn affects us. So Saturn was retrograde for a while, for past couple of months, and I felt it. I don't know about you guys, but I felt it. And my Saturn in my natal birth chart is pretty weak. Not pretty weak, it's actually zero. So I don't actually have any organizational skills or whatever, no self-discipline. So yeah, I have been struggling a lot with, as soon as I said that, you have Aquarius coming out. So yes, we have been healing, and Saturn is somehow helping us to heal in a way that it's showing us reality. It's showing us what is practical and what is real and how you should be and what you can do physically, and you know, how you can work so hard that you actually manifest it. So it, by the end of the day, it's about working really, really hard, without thinking about will you get anything in return or not, without thinking about if it's destined or not, without thinking about if your birth chart says something or not. Once you start working really hard towards something, you can get it by sheer effort of yours alone, whatever that you want. It might come late, it might be delayed, but it will come because you have worked for it. And Saturn tells us that whatever you do, it's never going to go to waste. Like karma, if you do good karma, you will receive good karma. If you do bad karma, somewhere down the line, you will realize what you had done or to the other person, or to, you know, to screw yourself, basically. And similarly, if you work really hard, even if you know that there is nothing, absolutely nothing out there for you, still if you keep building and keep investing, that's India, guys. There's a vendor outside selling vegetables. Anyway, so you will get your dues. I'm not going to say you will get in time. No, sometimes you will get it really late, but you will get it definitely, because no effort goes to waste and justice is there. In India, there is one saying in Hindi, they say, Bhagwan ke ghar der hai par andher nahin, which means that there can be delay in justice, but not but justice cannot actually be denied. So it can be delayed but not denied. So once you realize that and start trusting that, whatever you want to manifest, you can just start building on it and decide to never give up. Obviously, if you have picked up a really bad idea and you have started working on it, obviously you need to reconsider it once in a while, where the hell you are going, where are you headed, and then change your course and make course correction and take a different path if it's not serving you. That's a different story. But once you have decided that you want to achieve something in your life, keep going. Like, change your path, change your ways, but don't change your goal. What is your goal? your goal should not be self-serving, first of all. If your goal is self-serving, then you might get discouraged, demotivated. But if you attach your goal as a Piscean to something which is beneficial for a lot more people other than just you, then you might find it even more, you might find it more motivating for you, because you're not doing it for yourself. And Pisceans are sacrificial in nature. They hardly do anything for themselves. They want to do it for the other people. That's how they feel, you know, like they are actually doing something worthwhile. So make a goal which is for other people and start working on it, and don't give up. This is the card coming out for you. This is somebody starting on a journey with lot of enthusiasm, lot of great ideas, lot of energy, lot of spark and freshness. This is somebody who is very enthusiastic to explore. This is also passion, ambition, dream, taking action. This is taking action. And this is the bottom of the deck, single card. And the card which is coming out from between is the Piscean card, which is the moon, which is the Piscean card. So you might be feeling that there is a lot of confusion around you, things that you don't understand, things that you are still trying to get answers to, things that are hidden from you. But one thing is clear, that you are independent. There's nobody stopping you. You are the only person who is obstructing your way. And if you are happily single, if you're single, you have to be happy, definitely. Nobody else is going to come and make you happy. So make sure that you're happy. Eat good food. Be in a good mental space. Don't put garbage in your head. Like, don't pull yourself down. Only build yourself. And start working on your dreams. Start building. Start taking action. Start being passionate and enthusiastic about something that you really, really care about. So let's begin your reading, Pisces. So this reading is for Pisces for October 2018, Pisces Sun, Moon and Rising. Two cards that came out for you. First was Major Arcana Star card, which is Aquarius, which deals with Saturn. Saturn is the ruler of Aquarius. And also Uranus is a ruler of Aquarius, but Saturn is also the ruler of Aquarius, in Vedic astrology at least. And then Capricorn is flipping out for you. So you are dropping some of your temptation. This card fell down on the floor. So some of you are definitely coming out of some toxicity, something that was holding you back, something that was not serving you, something that was burning your all the four corners, your stability. So you were standing on something which was not worth, which was not a good foundation. So, and that foundation was actually killing your potential. So now you are dropping all those burdens and toxicity and temptations that was wasting your time and basically maybe some of you were procrastinating. So you're dropping all that. And you're by the way, what I was saying is Capricorn is also ruled by Saturn, again a fire sign. Libra, I'm getting Libra, okay. I'm also getting Aquarius. So Libra, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, definitely dealing with some of those signs. Still you are in a very early stages. You are not the pro. You are in the early stage, moving towards your dream. You might have a small team of people which are still learning, or you are the one learning along the journey. Ten card Celtic cross for Pisces Sun Moon. October 2018 messages. Okay, let's begin. Pisceans, Bottom of the deck, the World card. Can you believe that? You are wrapping up. You are ending huge cycles. You are beginning new ones. You already have the Ace of Swords that came up for you. Now you have the World card, which is again Aquarius, Leo, Scorpio, and Taurus. Some fixed energy, something was that was obstructing you, is not now going to lift up, and you are wrapping up a cycle, starting something fresh, new beginning, new journey, ending old patterns, starting new patterns. And the first card out for you is the Four of Wands. So solid foundation, like I was saying, your old foundation was not worth building upon, so it was burning your potential. So what is burning your potential? Now you're burning from within with a desire to pursue some goals and dreams and desires, to build some foundation. Now this foundation can only come to you once you have decided on something and you are literally into it, like day and night working towards it, and making a lot of physical effort and not just thinking it in your head, which a lot of Pisces do. Don't do that and start building something like a family, like a commitment or a home. This is your crossing card. So something is obstructing you, where a lot of people have different ideas and a lot of conflicting opinions, or there are people around you who are still trying to tie you down. So you are breaking that cord. You're breaking that cord, cutting that cord with your own truth, your own understanding, your own desires and your own idea. So you're breaking that cord that they are trying to put around you, or the chain that they are trying to put around you. Bottom of the reed is the Mother of Wands. Some of you can be dealing with a fire sign, Leo, Sag, Aries. This is someone, this can be you basically. This is someone who is very passionate about their goals. They know what potential they have. There is this egg which is a lot of potential, and somebody is protecting these eggs. This can be ideas, this can be anything that you are trying to protect, but you are not utilizing it. You are still protecting it, you are trying to nurture it so that in due time it you know, it will give you results. But right now you're just sitting out on an idea and not doing anything. You're just protecting it. You're passionately protecting it, defending it. So maybe these are the people opposing you, and here you are defending your wand. The Hangman, which is a Piscean card in the past. So the Hangman in the past is telling me you were hanging upside down like a bat, basically. So basically you are trying to look at something from a different angle, from a entirely different perspective. You didn't want to block your view. You didn't want to think about things from superficial level. You wanted to go deep within to look for your answers. You wanted to consider everything before you can start building something new. So you took your took a back seat and started questioning and reconsidering things that had happened, analyzing things that have happened. Now again this card is coming up as your crowning card. So you are definitely single, or on your mind you want to be single. Like in your head you are like, I have to be free, and I'm glad that I'm free now. I can like breathe. And you withdrew yourself in the past from something, and now you are free, or you are still making an effort to be free and comfortable and cozy in your own space. You're trying to understand what you have, what you don't have, and how you can use it, and how I think you're also determining your value, how much value you have. Look at these two cards, they are very similar. Almost very similar cards, like in a shape of a diamond. Maybe you are considering how like you are a diamond and you have to go through a lot of polishing and a lot of rubbing on the edges and lot of polishing and pressure basically to be a diamond. is what I'm getting here. So some of you are realizing your value. I'm also getting some of you realizing your market value. I don't know what means. That means I think you are trying to sell something and you are trying to determine its value. This is in future, Sun of Cups. So again, this is Piscean card. Both of these cards are Piscean. So Sun of Cups is somebody very naive, someone who is emotionally expressive. They tell people about their emotions and how they feel about them. They are very emotionally like telling people like they like them or they love them. It is basically someone telling you I love you, but they actually may not commit. They just express what they are feeling, so they may not give you commitment, but they are feeling, and it can be an offer. Like I said, you are considering where you have to invest, how much you have to invest. Was it worth investing? What was it worth putting in the effort? Do you want to keep putting in effort in whatever that you were putting in effort? So basically, you are trying to understand, is it you are having second thoughts about something. So this is your investment and commitment. This is where you are thinking, should I build on this? Should I build on this opportunity that I have, like I said, a business or a commitment or starting a something financially new? It can be something physical in nature, like materialistic in nature. So do you want to buy it? Do you want to grow this, basically like a seed? Do you want to sow this seed? You're thinking about that. How much effort will it take? You're thinking about that. This is also something solid universe is offering you, like a opportunity. Do you want to take this opportunity? It can go away if you don't take it with both your hands. Both of your hands. Now this is Father of Cups again. So Son of Cups is looking at the Father of the Cups like this. So you are maturing, basically. I think you are becoming an adult, Pisces. You are becoming an adult. You are becoming independent and self-sufficient. You are you are going in isolation looking for your answers. So you are very enlightened. You are discarding other people's view and agendas, how they are trying to hold you back. And you are trying to build your own foundation and your own house and your own security. You are defending what you want in life very fiercely. You are defending some of your ideas, some of your talents very fiercely. And you are taking stock of your situation. You have an opportunity. And here you are becoming an adult. So taking responsibility, but you have a lot of fear. You fear this. Will I be able to take it? Also, this is someone who expresses freely like a child. Emotions. This is someone who is very very much in charge, like they also feel a lot, but they don't show it. They are very much in control of their emotions. So maybe you are mastering your emotions. Mastering your emotions. Outcome is the Two of Wands. So Two of Wands is telling me that you are deciding on a path. Which path to take, how to proceed further. So you have seen a lot, like this is the world that you have seen. This is where you are coming from. You have seen a lot. You have traveled, you have seen a lot, you have experienced a lot. And now you're thinking about which journey to take next, which journey to start next, which way to go, what is my next step? This was your foundation that has been burned down, something that you were building and it's not there anymore. Something came crashing down. Now you have to start something new because universe is offering you something new and you have to start from the scratch. Plant that seed and build this tree again. Grow this tree again. This is you nurturing yourself, your self-esteem, your self. You're being self-reliant, I'm getting here, or you're taking care of somebody like around you. This is you. some of you have gone through a heartbreak and a three-party situation, a lot of confusion. Someone has kept you in a dark, but you're getting out of it. You're cutting out all the bullshit and you're working slowly towards building your dream. Whatever came down, it's ended. Time to build something new. So that was your message, Pisces. I hope you enjoyed, and in case you resonated, kindly drop me a comment. I really appreciate it. See you again next month. Bye bye.